So thank you for making time to speak this afternoon,
Ilya.
I'm really interested to know when and where your love affair with the violin began.
My love affair with the violin began when I was 7 years old and I lived in USSR. And it started not immediately. My love affair with music didn't start immediately with the violin, because my grandfather and my mother were the pianists, so they really wanted me to play piano. And I didn't like it that much. And at that time in Russia was a period that all the leaders were dying one after another, like Brezhnev, Chernenko, Andropov, every year. And the sign that someone died was a violin music on the TV. Strangely, I don't know why. And I just said, look, piano cannot cry like the violin. And maybe, I think I'm right. So that's how my love affair with the violin began. And we had a fantastic teacher at the time in Novosibirsk, in Russia, where I was born, Zahar Brun, who is world famous. I think he's one of the most famous teachers for the violin. And I spent my first five years with him. I was very lucky.
Can you remember, and could you play for us, the first tune, the first piece that you felt proud that you knew as a child?
I actually don't remember it.
Yes, okay.
And I must say, the violin is every string instrument, the most difficult instrument. It takes about 3 or 5 years till you can make a decent sound,
yes,
on the string instrument compared to the piano, because anyone can touch the piano,
yes,
and sound will be not, maybe it will be not the horrid sound, but it will be not the something that will disturb you. It takes a lot of time, and you get the decent, I'm not talking about nice sound, decent sound on the string instrument. So I better not disturb.
And I assume you lived in an apartment?
Yeah.
And how did was it an apartment that everyone was happy for you to learn the violin? You didn't get complaints from the neighbors?
Actually, no. I never get complaints from the neighbors for playing violin. When we were very young with my sister, we get complaints about running through the apartments, but not for the playing violin.
Oh, right. And you trained in Austria, is that correct?
After finishing the school, pre-college, as you call it, in the United States, in Russia, I went to Austria to study with the wonderful professor Doris Warburg. And then, at the age of 20, she told me, you know, there is an audition in the Israel Philharmonic Orchestra for the concertmaster. They are looking for the concertmaster. I think you should try it, and you can learn there much more than from me.
And were you surprised at 20 to think that you would be a concertmaster of a major country's, particularly the Israeli Philharmonic? Were you surprised that she suggested this to you?
Very surprised. I was just shocked. I was shocked. I never thought about this. I never thought about this. But I was thinking, and I really got to this idea, and I started to prepare myself. I really tried hard, and in half a year, I've got the job. And I was the youngest concertmaster in the history of the orchestra.
In the whole world?
I think in Vienna Philharmonic, they had a few times the concertmaster of my age.
Yes.
But that's quite rare.
Yes. So was the term prodigy used around you?
Sorry?
The term prodigy, you know, as a child, were you called a child,
yeah,
prodigy?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, they called me like this.
Was that difficult to deal with? Did you feel?
Not really.
No.
I think the difficult thing is the transition from the child prodigy to the serious violin player.
Yes.
That's the difficult.
Yes.
And I think it was difficult to get the job of the Israel concertmaster, but the most difficult task was to keep this job.
And can you talk about that?
As the Gregory Petrogorsky said once, when you are invited is a good thing, but the really important thing when you are re-invited. So that's the thing. But since I'm already 18 years concertmaster there.
Well, congratulations,
yeah.
That's quite something. Can you remember when you went to audition?
Yeah.
Can you remember what you played there?
Of course I remember. It's quite similar with any great orchestra. You play Mozart violin concerto, you play Brahms violin concerto, or any romantic concerto, like Sibelius, like Tchaikovsky, like Beethoven, and you play a few orchestra excerpts, like Heldenleben, Life's Hero, Scheherazade, and stuff like that.
Yes,